A pen was a conscious purchase a few decades ago. It is an impulse decision today. The consumer is spoiled for choices. The industry environment is exciting and dynamic. Perhaps no company has done as much to transform the nature of the purchase of writing instruments in India than Linc Pen and Plastics Limited. One of the largest and most respected writing instrument brands in India today. Door to door. That is how Surajmal Jalan started Linc Pens from a small shop in Canning Street in 1976. Surajmalji started Linc with two simple objectives: producing a good ballpoint pen for an affordable price. But there was a problem. The technology for making quality ballpoint pens was not available in India. So Surajmalji selected to import the relevant technologies: ballpoint tips from Switzerland and ink from Germany. And that is how the Linc Supreme, India's first plastic refillable ballpoint pen, was launched in 1978.
वाकया है 1980s के आसपास का. माल बाहर पार्टियों को जाता था. नियम कानून यही था कि माल निकल गया हमारी कोई लायबिलिटी नहीं. आसाम में थोड़ा डिस्टरबेंस रहता था, सब आज भी है लेकिन पहले ज़्यादा ही था. पार्टी का माल गया, हमारे पास कोई खबर नहीं है. पार्टी आया, पूरा पेमेंट दिया, देखे बोला कि मेरा एक कंजाइनमेंट रॉबरी हो गया है. पेमेंट पूरा लेके उसका हिसाब क्लियर करके मिस्टर एसएम जालान ने उनको उसका 50% रिटर्न कर दिया. हम लोग सब सकपका गए, ये क्या कौन सी दातारी हुई. बोले यही तो है.
Lower priced and far better product than available options, the Linc refill quality was so widely appreciated that consumers would inevitably ask for a Linc refill instead of throwing the pen away after it had been consumed.
Hello everybody. I joined Linc in 1981, soon after my high school. I would carry pens in a sample bag and visit shop to shop selling Linc pens. I did this for nearly 4 years. This exposure did two things. It made me learn a great deal about the ground realities and gave me confidence, immense confidence. I felt I could sell any pen in any quantity.
Linc legacy. 1984 brought a moment of pride when Linc set up its first manufacturing unit in Serakol near Kolkata. In 1992, Linc tied up with Mitsubishi Pencil Company of Japan to introduce the world famous Uniball, ball pens and roller pens. Today, Mitsubishi owns a 13% stake in Linc.
When we launched Uniball products in 1992, when we tied up with the Mitsubishi Pencil Company of Japan, we launched this Uni SAR ball pen, and the price of this SAR ball pen was more than double of what was available. Even though it's more expensive than the local products, but the quality was really very good. So, you know, I thought that yes, we will be able to sell it. But what happened that after 2-3 months, our customers, they started returning the pen because of its high cost. You know, we promoted this product through local exhibitions. I also asked our customers, our dealers and distributors, that there is no need to sell one box at a time to a customer, to your customers. You could try selling one pen to each of your customers, and I guarantee that once they buy one pen, they will definitely come back to you asking for more. And this is how SAR ball pen became popular, and SAR ball pen started selling at premium.
1995, a confident Linc announced its IPO.
The Linc IPO was a very proud moment for us. For the first time, we got a measured return of our consistent band investment when the issue was oversubscribed by 12 times. The equity fund that flowed in was the cornerstone on which the Linc edifice was finally erected.
Linc innovation. The mid-1990s. Internet, globalization, economic liberalization. As these realities converged, consumer aspirations began to evolve. Linc was at the right place, at the right time, with the right products and the right capacity to not merely sell more products but to transform the Indian market in various ways. Linc didn't just cater to existing demand, the company created demand instead. It introduced a non-sharpening pencil for the first time in India, following a tie-up with Benzia of Taiwan. Price, rupees 5. Linc priced products so attractively that it no longer became necessary to retain the old pen after the refill ran out. Linc became India's first company to introduce Linc Star Line, the longest writing pen with a capacity to write 5,000 meters, three times more than a regular ball pen. Linc launched products for the first time in India, introducing Tip Top, a pioneering retractable ball pen. Price only 2 rupees 50 paise. Linc became the first Indian writing instruments company to extend from manufacturing, India's only writing instruments brand to extend into marketing and branded retail stores called Just Linc and Office Linc. Linc didn't just make products, the company created new product categories instead. The first to introduce a gel pen, High School, for just rupees 10. Then launched Smart OBG, the first refillable oil-based gel pen, for a mere rupees 5. Followed by Twin, a pen and pencil within the same writing instrument body, for the first time in India. And finally launched a pioneering consumer pack of 3 pens for rupees 20. Linc created new price points, provided a wider product choice, innovated product categories, grew the market and evolved the product. Linc, pride of India. Linc is not just a popular Indian writing instrument. It is a respected global brand. Preferred by demanding users in more than 50 countries, the number one writing instrument brand in a number of countries. Recognized as a star export house of India 3 terms running. Exports now rising to as high as a third of its revenues. Linc, popular brand. Linc's brand stands for a simple recall. If it is Linc, it must be good. Linc has connected deeply with its target audience. Linc products were endorsed by icon Shah Rukh Khan for 3 years in 2008 that enhanced brand visibility. Linc's unique loyalty program, Club Linc, offered dealers privileges from a chance to meet Shah Rukh Khan to seeing IPL matches live, to interacting with celebrities during IFA events. Linc's Spell Linc English Vocabulary Competition is conducted in more than 1,200 schools and 5 lakh students across 8 cities. The result is that Linc's revenues are rising steadily from rupees 25 crores in 2000 to rupees 100 crores in 2004-05, rupees 200 crores in 2010-11, and more than rupees 300 crores today.
Until 2008, the Linc products were sold in the international market, mainly under OEM and private label brands. Since then, with change in our international strategy, we have been able to market the products under our own brand. Linc has now emerged as a reputed name in the international market.
Linc, champion products, one after another. Linc has transformed the writing habits of millions of Indians in the last 40 years. Through a number of popular champion products. Linc Glycer, for smooth and easy writing. Launched in 2005, the highest selling pen in Linc's history, among the highest selling pens in a number of countries. Linc Ocean Gel, highest selling gel brand. Launched in 2003, pioneering packaging of 3 pens for rupees 20. Helped price pens beyond rupees 5 each. created a new industry price point, Linc Smart OBG. The future is full of promise. Launched in 2002, sells 60 million writing instruments each year. Linc Twin, the first of its kind writing instrument. A super smooth ball pen that can also be used as a lead pencil. Two in one. Linc Responsible Citizenship. Linc is not just a successful brand, it is a socially responsible company as well. Linc launched Refill More, an environment-friendly initiative encouraging customers to reuse the writing instrument body through the purchase of refills, saving plastic, helping the world. Linc World-class manufacturing facilities. Linc's showpiece manufacturing facilities are located in Jungalpur, Falta SEZ and Serakol on the outskirts of Kolkata. The company's production capacity is more than 2 million pieces per day, one of the highest in India. Linc has invested extensively in automation, integration and global certifications like ISO 9001:2008 and SA 8000:2008. Linc, the best is yet to be. Linc is poised for the big leap. The company's Vision 2020 is a statement of exciting intent. Linc will continue to innovate new products, enter new markets, and diversify into related stationery products. The result is expected to be dramatic. Linc expects to more than treble revenues in just 5 years, emerging as a rupees 1,000 crore company by 2020.
Linc Pen by 2020 would be a 1,000 crore company. And I'm sure my team and all my distributors will make it happen.